3D Max.
They get back on. They get back on. They get back on. They get back on. Can't get any advice on how to.
We just been a much better team. Like, we've come together, like, everybody's understanding their role, establishing, you know, what they do for the team, you know, just being more cohesive, I believe, and just really listening to what Coach Moki, you know, the game plan, like, she has for Natty. So, like, we need to be listening to her, and I think we have been, and trying to put that product on the floor. Like, we've been practicing hard from the starters to the bench. Like, everybody's been playing their role, so it's just been great to see.
Defend the basketball. I feel like we're not even the same team as we were when we played Auburn. I feel like we're gelling on the defensive end. We're kind of figuring out on the offensive end, just playing defense and helping each other, because when we help each other, it makes it everybody's life so much easier. So
I would say my mentality to go into every game is to dominate, but most importantly defensively, and then just letting the game come to me.
Super excited to play against Auburn. Obviously we lost before, so this game is really one that it's not personal for me to play in. I know it's personal for the whole team, you know, because we lost. So, but it wasn't a game we were supposed to lose. So I think that, you know, we're just going to come out and dominate and then, you know, treat it like any other game.
We have to throw the first punch. I feel like that's the main thing. But locking down defensively and executing our offense is something that we didn't do our first game against Auburn.
Guarding the ball, guarding, defending, transition and everything will work out.
Hey guys, I hope everybody is doing well. I want to go over one more thing before we watch this quick documentary. I watched some of these clips and I got nothing but respect for this girl, Barker. And this was from the Texas A&M game. Shout out to this girl for being solid. I respect it.
Man, that's my fault.
What about the chippiness? And I see more chippiness than other ball games. Why?
No comment.
You got comment, AC?
No.
Okay. Do you think there was more chippiness out there than other games?
No comment.
What did you think of the environment? I know you had a rowdy home crowd, rowdy visiting crowd. Mm-hmm. I mean, did that kind of play a role in it?
I mean, it was great. 12th man came out. Thank you for student section for being there as well. It was loud. It was fun. I mean, you know what I'm saying? It's everything you want in a basketball game, you know? But, sorry, we couldn't put out for the fans, but
why was Morrow having such a big game?
Man, that's my fault. That's my fault. I'll take accountability. That's my fault.
Much respect for this young, beautiful woman right here. I wish her well on her journey. I want to watch this. I watched this with my daughter. It was really good. It should be taking us right to the time the game starts, so I'm going to play this. And then we'll get ready for the game.
This is the most popular woman in women's basketball. She is a former NCAA champion that has paved the way for young girls across the world looking to monetize their skills. Over the past few years, she has taken the national spotlight in the realm of women's basketball, earning more money in the process than stars like Caitlin Clark. In this video, we will take an exclusive dive into the skill set of Angel Reese to answer the question, how good is Angel Reese actually? Growing up in Maryland, Reese was no stranger to talent in the basketball realm. Both of her parents were hoopers themselves, and this would pay great dividends for Angel early in her career. Her mom, who ironically also goes by Angel Reese, played college and professional basketball on a pro team in Luxembourg. Her father, Michael Reese, played basketball at Boston College and Loyola University. He was a star player at Loyola and would even go further to becoming a pro overseas. Talk about having some great DNA. Sheesh.
So that's how they're growing so fast. They're hiring freelancers. Look what they're doing with AI experts.
Her love for basketball would start at a very early age, as her mom would take her to rec league games that she played in when Angel was just a child.
That's how we do it, right? She was very energetic, very self-driven, very competitive, very headstrong.
This is where Angel would develop her love for the game, eventually bringing in over $1.8 million through name, image, and likeness deals. To put this into perspective, star player Caitlin Clark only generated around $800K in similar deals. Entering high school in 2016, Reese was set to make her name known throughout the country as one of the top women's basketball players. She was the number two overall player in the class of 2020 and the number one wing as ranked by ESPN. During her high school career, she led St. Francis to three straight IAAM championships and two conference titles, averaging 18 points, 20 rebounds, and 5 assists per game for her career. Wait, hold on, let me repeat that again. Averaging 20 rebounds per game for her career. I'ma just let that sink in.
Hello? What?
She was also named Player of the Year by the Baltimore Sun after her junior and senior seasons, and was also named to the USA Today First Team. Reese would go on to build an impressive resume after earning All-Metro First Team honors by the Baltimore Sun for three seasons straight, and being named to the Jersey Mike's Naismith High School Trophy Girls Watch List. With such a decorated high school career, Reese would hit the ground moving as she transitioned into college. A Baltimore, Maryland native, Reese transferred to LSU after completing two seasons at Maryland. During her second season with Maryland, she put up 17 points and 10.6 rebounds per game. After earning multiple All-America honors following her sophomore season before entering the transfer portal, Reese would lead the Terrapins to the Sweet 16 in 2022 as their top scorer.
Angel Reese is supposed to be rocking with.
Prior to LSU, Reese became the first Maryland sophomore to average a double-double since 1975. She would arrive at LSU as one of the most dynamic players in the country. Just her sophomore season, Reese would make one of the largest impacts to a program in women's basketball history, leading the SEC in both scoring and rebounding with 23 points per game and 15.4 rebounds per game. She would become the fourth player in conference history to lead the league in both categories. When evaluating how good a player actually is, there is one common theme that seems to be consistent no matter the player: broken records. Angel Reese would go on to set an NCAA record with 34 double-doubles during the season, 23 of them being the most in SEC history to begin a season, according to ESPN.
On Friday, Angel Reese tied the SEC single-season double-doubles record set by Tierra McCowan, and now it is all hers with 11 points and 11 rebounds. That is her 32nd double-double this season, the most in SEC history ever.
While double-doubles would become Reese's signature trademark, the young star would also set the SEC records with 240 made free throws, showing her tenacity to be aggressive and score inside, which leads to more fouls. However, December 14th of 2022 would be a special date for Angel Reese, as she accomplished a feat no one has done before. Reese was the only NBA, WNBA, and Division I men's or women's player in the last 20 years to have at least 30-plus points, 15-plus rebounds, 4-plus assists, 4-plus steals, and shoot over 80% in the same game. For what it's worth, many people compare the game of Angel to that of a Dennis Rodman, and I can't disagree with that. A forward who is popular, plays with tremendous hustle, and most importantly, can rebound. If you think I'm bluffing, Reese set the LSU single game rebounds record with 28 boards on January 5th against Texas A&M. 28 boards.
15-0 Angel Reese, 26 points, but 28 rebounds. What is your mindset rebounding on the glass like a monster you are tonight?
I know that if I don't get the ball, I need to go get it for another opportunity. So if my teammates miss, they know I'm going to go get the rebound. I need to go back up or kick it out to them for another shot. So that's my specialty. I do whatever it takes to get a win. So that's what I did tonight.
In the NCAA tournament, Reese.
And that's what I'm expecting Angel to do tonight. She's going to do what we need her to do and this team to do for us to get a big, big win tonight. The ladies are getting ready right now. Let's look at some of these picks. Angel Reese with the great hairdo, looking beautiful. Poa getting ready. HVL. Miss Flage Johnson. And today is also Samaya Smith's birthday. Everybody throw a 5 in the comments. We love Smith. Cannot wait to have her back next year. She's going to be amazing. She was looking so, so good this year. Yes, we're ready. The game is going to be starting soon. I have it here. Okay, let me play this. Somebody block Trashy David from the comments, please. Thank you guys for the new intro. I don't know if my mods are here yet. Imagine having to subscribe to talk crap in the comments. How bored are you? Thank you guys. I'm okay. Let me see. How was your experience? You said you went to the game. I met and took pics with the ladies on Monday at the Texas A&M games. The ladies were very pleasant, took pics and signed autographs. I was injured on the job and couldn't drive. Thanks, nephew, for driving. Congratulations. And you see that testimony of how their energy are. They get like this bad rep of being trashy, of not having class. And look at a fan who met them, said that they were pleasant. They took pics and signed autographs. Well, I hope for your full recovery from your injury, and I'm happy that you were able to meet them, and I'm glad that they treated you kindly. Yes, we need it, we need it, we need it. Let me do a refresh. Yes, it's Samaya Smith's birthday today, and actually tonight is my husband's and my daughter's birthday at midnight, the 23rd. My daughter will be 3, so I'm super excited. Okay, and that's the reason why, like, the way they went to the press conference after, the way they was talking, like, we want to beat y'all today, period.
DJ3D Max.
Ooh, they get back on. They get back on.
DJ Brother.
They get back on.
can't give these advice. Don't have to kill, cause they don't listen to nothing. Be macho man and hook. See, hop out with that buddy. I ain't giving any advice on but how to go to church on Sunday. This a rollie, not a stop. Watch, don't ever stop. This the flow that got the block hot.
Okay, we're live, hot, we're live, we're live. Give me my respect. Here we go, guys. LSU come out swinging. We need this big
or an assistant.
Win.
It doesn't matter. It's a championship
All
culture.
Right,
indeed it is.
Now.
It's LSU right now celebrating the last championship. Here we go, LSU Auburn.
It's rematch time in Baton Rouge tonight. Number 13, LSU and Auburn. And the first meeting had us on the edge of our seats. This is SEC Women's Basketball presented by Regions. Back on January 14th, there was a record crowd at Auburn when LSU came to visit. And the Auburn Tigers picked up their fourth top 25 win under Johnny Harris and handed LSU only its second loss of the season. Two for Scott Grayson. Ice water in her veins. LSU has won 16 straight games. That is in danger right now.
We fed off of the crowd. I don't know who they were here for. I knew bodies in the seats and it was showtime. They wanted the show. We can give them one too.
Mingo Young took it for Reese. Underdogs can do unbelievable things, and Auburn did today. That was incredible to witness. Courtney Lyle alongside the Hall of Famer, Carolyn Peck. How did Auburn beat LSU in the first meeting?
Well, they did it in three major ways. One, Auburn controlled the tempo. Two, they did not allow LSU any three-point shots. And three, they battled with LSU on the boards. They only lost that battle by two rebounds. So if they can battle on the boards, could they pull an upset here in Baton Rouge? We don't know.
Hey, it's going to be hard, though. LSU is a much improved team, specifically on the defensive end. But when you play the LSU Tigers, you always got to be ready for double-double trouble. Anissa Morrow and Angel Reese.
I call it Reese and the Beast. You look at these two women averaging double-doubles. They are responsible for 41% of LSU's points per game and 48% rebounds per game. So the key for Auburn, can they keep these women off the board and out of the paint? We are surely soon to see.
Kim Mulkey said this week her team knows who's beaten them in the past.
Oh, you know they've been talking about that this rematch for a long time.
We have you guys the seen the moderators is on Chicago or
what have you seen
here
there
yet?
From the Tigers?
Well, they have become more aggressive out on the perimeter, and you can be aggressive and pressure when you trust your teammates that are behind you. Building that trust, that's what with defense, it is 1-2 and energy, but you also have to have team trust.
So here we go. Auburn tries to beat LSU for multiple times in the same season. It would be the first time since 1994 if they can pull off the road upset. Angel Reese over to Anissa Morrow, and she is fouled.
The connection between those two. Defense is paying so much attention to Angel Reese and getting Anissa Morrow on this team. She knows how to cut into those open areas.
Now we were asking Anissa Morrow about, you know, coming here, rebounding alongside Angel Reese. It's like they battle for every rebound and they're on the same team.
Well, Anissa Morrow said, I rebound, but I need the guards to rebound as well.
Kim Mulkey led this LSU program to its first national championship last year. She went in the transfer portal, got some key pieces, Anissa Morrow being one of them. And she told us, Morrow is one of the best undersized post players I've ever coached.
Well, she has coached some great undersized post players. Remember Nina Davis that played at Baylor? And also, Melissa Smith really was undersized, but she could jump out of the gym.
There's Auburn's starting five, and you have to circle number 23, Honesty Scott Grayson. Started her career playing at Baylor for Kim Mulkey and had 21 points in the first meeting.
Well, and she said after that first meeting, she had a little extra motivation. And I think when a player is playing against a former coach. She wants to really demonstrate the improvement in her maturity.
The hesitation from Taylen Collins right on the SEC logo. LSU starting five. We mentioned Anissa Morrow and Angel Reese, but Flaze Johnson, not only is her offense, but her defense has really stepped up, and she's been a key weapon this year. She was a part of that national championship squad last year.
Well, she was the kind of and other last year. Now she's had to step up and take on a leadership role, not just offensively, but defensively. I really look at her as being that glove, that Gary Payton for the LSU Tigers.
Kaylin Duhon just swiped it out of Michaela Williams' hands. Here's Scott Grayson taking the screen. Duhon waiting from the screen for Savannah Scott. She gets it to her inside, and Savannah Scott battling down low.
Auburn is so patient offensively. They do not get bothered by the aggressive defense of LSU. They just run their stuff. That's what they did in the first meeting.
And they really dictated tempo and used as much of the shot clock as they could. Haley Van Lith's shot a bit short.
You can see Auburn run like their motion offense, get the ball from one side to the other. Ball reversal is key when you're patient and then take care of the ball.
Mingo Young over to Duhon for a two. Swish, got it.
The confidence of Auburn. This is what they demonstrated the first time they met. Really calm, cool, and collected.
This is an Auburn Tiger team, too, that could really use this win over LSU. They're 5-7 in the conference. They've lost some close games. Anissa Morrow on the opposite block. Janiyah Mingo Young setting things up. Scott Grayson got tripped up. Mingo Young will reset.
Flaze Johnson has the responsibility of covering Honesty Scott Grayson.
And there's a travel.
Sharing the basketball. Flaze Johnson attack, reading the defense and getting rid of the basketball. Not a bailout pass, but a pass with a purpose.
She was the SEC Freshman of the Year last season, has upped her scoring, upped her rebounding, and as we said, upped her defense.
Well, she came to Baton Rouge this summer, went to work with this freshman, Michaela Williams, coming to town.
Reese has her first points. And Michaela Williams helped really raise Flaze Johnson's game this summer.
Competition will do that. When you bring talent in, and that's what you got to love about Michaela Williams, she saw the talent that was here and was not afraid to step in, said, I can play at this level.
Johnny Harris is in her third season as Auburn's head coach. They have three wins against the net top 30 this season, LSU being one of those. Right now, Charlie Cream has them as part of the last four in. They're trying to get back in the NCAA tournament for the first time since 2019.
If you look at Auburn, they've lost four SEC games by single digits. They lost by six to Alabama. They lost by two to Arkansas, three to Vanderbilt, and three to Ole Miss. If they were able to close those games out, just think about how high Auburn would be sitting right now in the SEC race.
So I think we had a contact issue. We need everyone to be able to see in this game.
Well, at least I need to.
Yeah. Duhon almost had herself another steal. Michaela Williams short. Angel Reese with the hustle for the rebound. Flaze in the corner, short. Auburn will take their transition opportunities when they get them. Mingo Young in and out.
That's a good decision, I thought, by Mingo Young. When you get to the free throw line, you better make up your mind what you're going to do with the basketball.
Angel Reese was looking for Anissa Morrow going fast break. This is going to stay with the LSU Tigers. Van Lith's got to get it in. feeding Anissa Morrow. And Angel Reese takes a hard fall. And that's the first foul against Savannah Scott of Auburn.
Look, part of everybody's scouting report is not where the shot's going to be taken from, but where is Angel Reese? You've got to try to keep her off the glass. And denying that, you almost do have to foul her in order to keep it from happening.
Michaela Williams. Yeah, we were talking to Johnny Harris about defending Angel Reese. It's not the first shot. It's the second and third shot she gets in one possession that really kill you.
She has that second bounce.
Yes.
So after she goes up for the shot or even after an offensive rebound, if she doesn't make it, she's going to be there for the putback.
She's had 58 straight games in double figures. LSU on a 6-0 run here. Taylen Collins in trouble. 8 seconds on the shot clock. Mingo Young. And 3 seconds called against Auburn. Third turnover by the Auburn Tigers. You know, one of the things I thought, too, that was really helpful for Auburn in the first meeting against LSU is that Owendamola Akinbolawa was available. She's out with an injury right now. She actually got the start in that game, and that gives him a little more depth and size in the post.
Absolutely. Akinbolawa was able, may not have showed up in the stat sheet, but she had a physical presence to match up with Angel Reese and Anissa Morrow.
That's going to be a 3-second violation on LSU on this end.
And Taylen Collin in the first meeting was all over the glass. If she wasn't getting rebounds, she was tipping the ball out to create those extra opportunities for Auburn.
Yeah, she had 7 rebounds in that game. Flajay Johnson, there's her defense stepping up. And the bucket. Ito run.
LSU in control. The improved defense of the LSU Tigers. A lot of that has to do with Big Bo on the steal and score for LSU.
I'm 24. They know five, they asking like who the four. Spend my time, I don't know who do it more. You know, grinding, what do you do it for?
Man, I gotta win, I don't care if I lost again. I gotta shoot, I don't care if it's off again. I tell the truth, I don't like when it's false again.
We know you did sell, so you back on Washington. I got a new job, I come with a new offer. Coming correct, I know that they too proper. I watch the fat lady sing in the new offer. Trying to make change, I had to go too proper. They know that they hanging, my diamonds, they blinging. They know that they clinging, they too proper. And I know that they laming the stars where I'm aiming. I drop my whole five, got a new roster. Buy the big body kick, gotta come with it. Man, I feel like I'm Nick, gotta drum with it. If you keep throwing fists, then I'm done with it. Man, my life a relay, man, I'm run with it. Diamonds, they water, I had to go plumb with it. Like I'm on a yellow bus, had to go done with it. Hey, man.
She still started this game tonight. She's okay.
I mean, you look, she down goes Reese.
And then we never saw her again.
But you see the excitement? And look, after that, said, this is all of what college sports is all about. There's Tyrell Ward and Jordan Wright.
Returning the favor, cheering on the women. LSU men, two big wins in a row, beating ranked South Carolina, beating ranked Kentucky. Matt McMahon's got the Tigers going in the right direction.
Woo, that LSU, that SEC tournament is going to be lit in Nashville. Because I think every team has to be worried about LSU.
We talk about Angel Reese, too. By the way, she's eligible to come out and enter the WNBA draft, projected to be the sixth overall pick right now, but she could come back.
She could come back, but I think that Angel Reese, I think she's ready to dip her toe into the WNBA.
Kim Mulkey is going to love that. A shot clock violation. Again, defense has been the focus for LSU.
After the last couple of losses, Kim Mulkey really had 2 days, gave them 2 days off, and then the following practices were without basketballs. And so that's when you really show and emphasize what's important. It's defense. Great cut by Flyzae Johnson.
She's got 4 points. It's a 10-0 run now.
The sharing of the basketball for LSU has been so impressive tonight.
There's a lot of personalities on this LSU team. As honestly, Scott Grayson hits the three. That ends a four-minute scoring drought. But it's taken them a while to figure each other out and build that chemistry, but we're starting to see them peak at the right time.
Well, they're getting to learn each other. You see here, Anissa Morrow is going to catch it, and she knows exactly where Flajay is going to be off that back screen and delivers it. As a coach, yeah, you love it when you see it all work out.
Last year, Pola in the game now. She's inbounding for LSU. And throws it away. Honestly, Scott Grayson on the move.
And Anissa Morrow, a bigger defensive presence on Honesty Scott Grayson.
Kelly Van Lith trying to feed Angel Reese. It'll be back-to-back turnovers for LSU.
I think LSU is at their best when they bring Lastier Poa into the game and they can move Haley Van Lith off the ball into her natural shooting position.
Yeah, Haley Van Lith spent 3 seasons at Louisville, not a point guard, but she's been asked to fill that role here at LSU because they haven't had someone, they don't have anybody to play the point besides Lastier Poa, but now they're challenging Poa to step up even more, and you see the training staff taking a look at Haley Van Lith's arm.
And look, I can respect Haley Van Lith wanting to come to a program and learn from Kim Mulkey, who was a great point guard in her own right, but understanding that she's got to expand her game if she wants to play at the next level. Look at the defense of Anissa Morrow. I love it.
Caitlin Duhon picks up her dribble. Marshawn Bostic. 6 seconds on the shot clock. Kick to the corner, Scott Grayson. Using all the shot clock.
And no panic, cool, calm, and collected.
That's a 6-0 run for Auburn now, and they've tied the game.
Talking about the men's SEC tournament, the women's SEC tournament's gonna be something to see.
Yeah, watch out, Greenville.
Woo! Woo!
Taylen Collins with the block. Scott Grayson one-on-one with Pola. She'll pull up and hit. 8-0 run for the Auburn Tigers. Last year, Pola turned in the corner, stepping over the defense. She is at her best when she's being aggressive.
The three from Honesty Scott Grayson. With the shot clock's running down, that shows this team is composed, not worried, not letting this crowd affect them.
Crowd wanted to travel there.
I'm watching the shot clock because Auburn now is being very patient, and you're almost better off. The deeper you can get into the shot clock before you take a shot, the less possessions LSU has. And if they get a shot clock violation, at least you get your defense set.
Fouls on last year, Poa, her first. Marshawn Bostic to inbound for Auburn. Scott Grayson this time guarded by Angel Reese. And that's a double dribble.
I thought Angel Reese hit the basketball out of her hands. That's the honestly Scott Grayson trying to plead her case. Nope. It was after the dribble. Yep.
Morrow got pushed way far away from the basket by Taylen Collins on that shot.
You're watching the shot clock down to 15.
Celia Sumbane, number one in orange, and 8 seconds now. Scott Grayson, a desperation three looked easy.
Oh my goodness.
Motivated playing against her old coach. 11 points for Honesty Scott Grayson. It's an 11-2 run for Auburn.
Just watching the maturity of Scott Grayson, how she has grown both on and off the court.
Second bucket of the evening for Angel Reese. Scott Grayson working for the last shot. And Bostic lost it.
Bostic tried to take off before she actually had control of the ball. She's so quick.
That's 7 turnovers for Auburn in this first quarter, but they have a 1-point lead.
They're fortunate with that one because those turnovers, they cost them in their last Alabama game.
Flahe Johnson checks back in for LSU, 3.6 on the clock. Van Lith lets it fly! Just like that, LSU grabs the lead.
You practice for situations. You only have 3 seconds left. Even when there's a breakdown, you stay collected. And Van Lith, bottom of the net for the Tigers.
What even is this?
Don't touch my things, gross.
Janice, when you bundle your home or renters with your auto, Progressive provides 24/7 protection for almost everything you own. But you really need...
My way...
Don't wanna balance, you just...
test me. It's gonna get messy. It's gonna get messy. Just bless me. Bless me. It's your bestie, Miss Westie. Just tryna bless me. Just bless me.
It's choices. Look, I just flipped the switch. Flip. I don't know nobody else that's doing this. Body start to drop, ayy. They wanna know me since I hit the top. Hey, this a rolling, not a stop. Watch, don't ever stop. This the flow that got the block hot. Got super hot. Hey, give me my respect. Give me my respect. I just took it left like on ambidex. I moved through London with the Euro step.
Yeah. Biggest phone. Yeah. Biggest phone. Big four flogging.
Look, look, and they say big four was you scared. They make diamonds up out of pressure. Put 100 on their head. It's about time they gotta respect us. I really need a 10 if I'm signing. Ain't nothing less in my mind. It gotta be special. My grind is just so excessive. They be talking down, but I don't ever let it get to me. Came to LSU my freshman year and we made history. I was trying to wait to serve the game. They wasn't tipping me. Soundtrack of my
down 10 in the fourth, but went on a 19-0 run to end the game.
Monster. Monster. Monster rebound by Petty. Too little?
How about Big Blue, guys?
C-A-T-S. Cats, cats, cats. How about that for the Kentucky Wildcats? That's a big win. Back here in Baton Rouge, Courtney Lyle and Carolyn Peck with you. That was a close first quarter. Both teams shooting over 50% from the field. For Auburn, they were led by Honesty Scott Grayson. 11 points in the first quarter. And we mentioned it. She started her career at Baylor playing for Kim Mulkey before transferring to Auburn.
Yeah, she was dismissed from Baylor, actually, and then decided to come to Baylor. She came to Auburn, and she played for Terry Williams. There was a coaching change, and then she got to play for Johnny Harris. And I asked Honesty, I said, who helped you through this? And she talked about her brother. Her brother plays ball overseas. They're very close. And in talking to Honesty, you could see how she has matured, grown up. She's really taken her game seriously. She's focused on her academics. I mean, it's just been great. And she said in playing against Kim Mulkey, she just wanted to show her how much she's grown.
Yeah, the mature factor is a big one. And Tyreek, her brother, has helped her do that. She said, Tyreek always told me, you're here for a reason. You're always going to have your family's support. We will always back you. They still talk, even though he's playing overseas in Romania right now. They talked yesterday on the phone, despite the time change.
Nice. So where was the biggest area of growth? And she said, you know, it's tough when you go to Baylor and you're playing, when you're going to a team that's loaded with talent, you come to Auburn and the ball is put in your hands and you are asked to take over. She said that's where she really gained a lot of responsibility.
Angel Reese with the bucket, and Honesty Scott Grayson, the leading scorer for Auburn this season, almost 18 points per game. Again, had 11 in the first quarter.
Angel Reese already 5 rebounds today.
Kim Mulkey really upset. That's the first on Flaget.
And Scott Grayson should be shooting 3 shots.
Three free throws coming for Scott Grayson. This is the bucket on the other end. And Honesty told us, freshman year at Baylor, I was quiet, I was shy. I wasn't a player that was going to speak up for myself. And she has totally done a 180 and transformed into that vocal leader.
Very confident when she spoke to us this morning at shoot around 2. I mean, you can tell that this is a player that is really honed her craft, and she's ready for the next level.
All 3 are good.
I think Flajay Johnson got her on the arm. It was just a little bit, a little tap, but still, if you make contact, that's a foul.
And honesty makes LSU pay with three free throws. The takeaway here by McKenna Eddings. Sydney Shaw, fire away!
That first meeting, that first win for Auburn, had to be a huge confidence booster for the Tigers, the Auburn Tigers, that they can play with anybody.
And then Yakaia Milton coming in and getting the block.
Well, turning defense into offense. And Sydney Shaw hadn't been in the game long, but she came in ready to knock down that three in transition.
She does that, and Auburn is now 4 of 5 from three-point range. This is a team that shoots 26% from three.
Special things have to happen to cause special outcomes.
8 points for Angel Reese.
One thing that I'm looking for, Courtney, is once we get to the second half, because Kim Mulkey talked about against Texas A&M that LSU got a little tired in the third quarter. Well, Auburn's already gone to their bench.
LSU doesn't have much of a bench. They only play 7, maybe 8 players. Look, LSU's shooting 50% from the field. Auburn's just shooting 62%. Shot for two.
Wow. Lighted up.
Was not cold on the bench, apparently.
That's talking about coming in ready. Now, for LSU, I mean, you got for sure buckets with Angel Reese and Anissa Morrow in the paint.
Reese calling for it high. There's a hold down low on Yakaia Milton for first.
You know, Milton is 18. She just turned 18 in February. But you see her improvement, the more and more experience that she gets. Tremendous leaper, shot blocker. She can run the floor.
She played volleyball in high school using that vertical.
I love multi-sport players. We talked about that this morning.
Anissa Morrow trying to bank it in. She was also a multi-sport athlete playing volleyball at a high level. Waiting in the wings. Can't hit from McKenna Eddings. Called an offensive foul on Anissa Morrow, and she's still slow to get up. Took a hard hit.
Now Morrow was going full speed ahead. Sydney Shaw, instead of running alongside Morrow, she got ahead of her to establish legal guarding position.
And stayed with her after Morrow made the pass.
The defensive intensity, can LSU maintain?
Up ahead to Van Litt. And she's fouled by Sydney Shaw.
This game back and forth. It's pretty incredible what Johnny Harris has done with this program. They have continued to get better and better. Came in first establishing defensively. Well, they're showing tonight offense is coming along as well.
Reese stopped by Scott. It's going to be Auburn basketball.
Here's the tough thing about Angel Reese. on the first shot, if she doesn't make it, she's not going to quit till she gets that second one. But tough defense by Savannah Scott for Auburn. The freshman ain't no back down and number 30 in orange.
The previous play is under review for a possible upgrade.
So they called a pushing foul on Angel Reese. They'll take a look and see if they have to elevate this at all. We'll let you know what happens when we come back.
These are my...
It's gonna be that breakout year where they're gonna be like, she really...
on my brain.
Karma is gon' come full circle. I ain't even mean tryna hurt you. Five on my shoes and my jeans from purple. Outfit came from Virgil. Can't get mad when you say I ain't worth it. I'll forever search you. Don't you let them curse you. Don't you let them work you. Karma is gon' come full circle. I ain't even mean tryna hurt you. Five on my shoes and my jeans from purple. Outfit came from Virgil. Can't get mad when you say I ain't worth it. I'll forever search you. Don't you let them curse you. Don't you let them work you. I'm living in this life, it's full of pain. This love going with the hurt, I think it's strange. It's hard to get these demons out my brain. I'm trying to fall in love right now, I can't. I'm trying to keep precision with my aim. The way that I do it, I ain't capping, I walk it, I'm getting into it. I'm giving my all and it come with the music. I'm going, I'm hungry, I'm eager to do it. You my lover, I gotta pursue it. I came out of be so okay. Any lane that I need, I take. Keep saying you'll leave, I stay. Keep playing to
the SEC regular season championship. What Kentucky did late against Mississippi State, this thing is going to be fun the rest of the way.
It is. It's the SEC. Everybody's vying to be in that top four going to the SEC tournament.
Nikki, you and I were talking about the pace of Auburn, the way that they've just been running it right at LSU. Give them a little taste of their medicine. It's going to be a good one.
It is. Back to you all.
It's been fun to be here courtside, guys. Just a two-point game. Want to let you know, too, they looked at that last foul, confirmed it was just a common foul on Angel Reese. Didn't need to upgrade anything there, so that's the first foul on Reese. Auburn has the two-point lead here now in the second quarter. Looking at their resume again, they're trying to get back in the tournament for the first time since 2019. And right now, Charlie Cream has them as part of the last four in. They would be an 11 seed at this moment.
I think that they have a better chance if they can try to get above the line, get up into that eight, at least the eight spot, seven spot in the final SEC regular season, and then perform well in the SEC tournament to secure a spot.
So Auburn has this game here against LSU. We're close to that SEC tournament. They will play Texas A&M Sunday, followed by Mississippi State. They go to Florida before heading over to Greenville to play in the SEC tournament.
Florida. Well, all of these teams, I mean, you look at Mississippi State, they're a team that also beat this LSU team. Florida's hit their stride late. So at this point, got to stay tuned in this final few weeks of the regular season.
You heard Steffi talking about pace in this game. How do you think it's helped Auburn?
Well, Auburn, especially early in this second quarter, executing their offense, being very patient. They're not allowing this to become a track meet.
Oh, my goodness.
Honesty Scott. 3 seconds.
Wow. They call a 3-second violation when Honesty Scott Grayson went leaping over Haley Van Lith and kicked her in the shoulder.
I mean, she literally jumped over her. But the officials call Anissa Morrow for 3 seconds.
And this is the third 3-second call that we've had in this game. They're going to send both teams to the benches and take a look at this.
The on-call ruling is a 3-second violation. We are observing for a possible unobserved foul.
Oh,
There was definitely contact. When Honestie Scott Grayson comes over, I mean, her shoe catches Haley Van Lith, looked like, on the head.
I think her leg grazed Haley Van Lith's left shoulder.
Yeah, I could see this being an unobserved foul.
Again, the original call was 3 seconds. It's a 3 second violation on Anissa Morrow.
And if they call that on Honestie Scott Grayson, that would just be her first foul of the ball game.
After review, there's no further penalty.
Okay, so didn't see anything that they wanted to change, so it was a 3 second violation on Anissa Morrow.
So Anissa Morrow in the paint for over, that was kind of quick. That was kind of a quick 3 second call.
It's something they're definitely watching again. They've called it three times tonight. And that's an offensive foul on McKenna Eddings. Just the first turnover for Auburn in this quarter. Again, they had seven turnovers in the first quarter. LSU in a bit of scoring drought here, 2.5 minutes, and Poa's going to fix it.
Last year, Poa can be kerosene to light the fire for LSU.
Ooh, I like that. We saw her do that in the Alabama game when LSU trailed by double digits at the locker room. She came out and started the third quarter and just lit LSU up, got them ready to go.
Kid Mulkey talks about how competitive Poa is, and that spirit on the floor can be infectious for the Tigers.
3 seconds, Scott Grayson. Wow! Four threes, tying her career high. We are in the second quarter. Reese back to the free throw line, but that's 17 for Honestie Scott Grayson.
She's done this a couple of times. Shot clock running down and doesn't panic. And she felt like that was going in on the release. Talk about a player playing on a mission. Number 23 in orange has it going on.
She has matched her season average right now at 17 points, and we're halfway through the second quarter.
Holy cow! But that's what she's got to do for Auburn to win. Scott Grayson has to be the first option and make her opponent figure out how to stop her, and then that will open up everybody else.
So Johnny Harris is now talking to the officials. Savannah Scott, by the way, for Auburn, picked up her second foul, so she's going to sub out Nakia Milton back in for Auburn with Angel Reese at the free throw line. Angel takes more free throws and has made more free throws than anybody in the nation this season.
Now, more often than not, Angel Reese is getting fouled going after she gets an offensive rebound. And Kim Mulkey knows when she needs a bucket, she can go to number 10 in white down low.
Auburn is on an 11-5 run. They hold a 2-point lead.
And LSU in a sagging man-to-man in the paint. And Auburn content to run in their motion offense.
Reese will bring it down the floor. Morrow working on Collins. And it's Auburn basketball.
And the quickness of Marshawn Bostic, she's just a pest defensively.
Today's her birthday, too.
That's right.
Leonel Rosario is heading to the table to check in for LSU for the first time tonight. She'll wait until a dead ball. Seven. Shaw short. Give it to Angel and let her cook. 11 points, 8 rebounds.
That's going to the bank right there. When you want to go where the money is, you find number 10 in white for LSU.
Now 59 straight games in double figures for Angel. Just missed Angel going down the court.
Angel Reese is going to work, catching it on the baseline. A little quick move from the short corner to get the finish. 11 points in this first half. One rebound away from getting a double-double.
Sydney Shaw, she has been such a spark plug off the bench. That's 7 points for her. In 6 minutes, not bad. Leah Del Rosario going up and fouled by Milton, her second.
You gotta be defensively disciplined. When the ball goes inside and you want to break that plane to block the shot, but when you have the length of Milton, if you just hold your hands straight up, you're going to do yourself all kinds of favors of making the offense have to take a tough one.
Julia Del Rosario at the free throw line. This right here is the future of LSU post presence.
We have seen her develop just from the start of this season to where she is now. You've seen her body transform. She's gotten in tremendous shape. You see the confidence that she is playing with on the floor. You know, after December, you're no longer a freshman in Kemp Walker's program, and she has grown up quickly.
Both of her parents played basketball. She said she wanted to continue the bloodline, keep it going.
I asked her, I said, what's it like going against Angel Reese every day in practice? She said, you know, I learn a lot. She's a great player. But then finish it by saying, I'm pretty good, too.
I love that confidence. Sydney Shaw taking the confidence shot, but off a little bit. That's a blocking foul on Caitlin Duhon, her second.
The Poa playing aggressive. That could have gone either way because it did look like a little bit of shove off by Poa. But that's what Kim Mulkey wants to see, that aggressive play from last year, Poa. I think when Haley Van Lith came in and really helping her to learn the point guard spot, Poa took a back seat, kind of went to that reserve mentality that she had playing behind Alexis Morris last season. And the staff of LSU went to her along with Angel Reese and told Poa, we need you. And in order for LSU to make a run, last year Poa is going to be a key element.
One of two free throws. Shaw with the board.
And you see how far off LSU is playing off of Marshawn Bostic.
This is going to stay with Auburn.
We saw Johnny Harris tell Marshawn, listen, she said, I'm okay with you stepping in and taking a jumper. Marshawn's just not comfortable taking anything but a layup.
Mingo Young off. She has not scored today. Somehow, Aaliyah Del Rosario just held up her hands and said, okay, let it go. I don't know how that went in the basket.
But I'll take it.
Bajay scouting ahead to Reese. High low to Del Rosario. Run LSU.
Marshawn Bostic's got to step in. At least gain the respect that she's going to look for that perimeter shot.
6 seconds. Shaw double teamed. And a shot clock violation.
Love it. See Angel Reese go congratulate Aaliyah Del Rosario of her tough defense inside. That just continues to build the confidence of that freshman.
She's come in and given LSU 6 points, 2 for 2 from the field. Lanes.
That's just tough. We saw her do that against Alabama in the second half. When her team needed a big play, Poa brought it.
She's got 7 points, and LSU has its largest lead. Auburn started the second quarter 2 for 4, but since then 2 for 13. And LSU will take it right back.
Just always active hands. The two players away from the ball, always engaged with what's happening. We need Poa to go get the ball for the top.
Again, let's try to kill some of this clock. Collins had it and lost it. So Poe will take a seat. Kim Mulkey sends in Michaela Williams.
Williams needs to come down the floor, be ready to spot up. You got plenty of time.
Flage instead for three.
God, turn me off.
Three-point field goal what? Pending review.
A 12-0 run for LSU.
Big Foe for three with the clock running down. LSU up 10.
Flage calls bank at the buzzer, and LSU on a 12-0 run. They are up 10 at the half. Let's get you back to the studio.
That is a way to end the half, without question. Take any momentum away that Auburn might have had. Dari, Nikki, Steffi here in studio. Good to have you with us. That 12-0, what changed? What started that run?
I'm going to talk about the play of Flage when she got into the game, Johnson, when she got into the game. She had the defensive assignment to shut down Honesty Grayson. And so I think that to me, Scott Grayson, that to me changed the tempo of the game, because now you have a Auburn team that is struggling offensively to score the basketball because of her defensive pressure. Yeah. And to me, that got them out of sync, which allowed LSU to start and do what they do best, and that's get out in transition and get going.
Well, I think that they got the ball to Angel Reese a little bit more. And I think Angel Reese is an underrated passer because she, from that high post position, she gave it up to her freshie for the easy two. I think good things happen when Reese gets the basketball. You and I were talking about the first quarter, not enough touches. And especially with Morrow, Morrow hasn't necessarily been really assertive so far in this first half. You had to have Flagey hold it down on the defensive end, really slow down Odyssey Scott Grayson the last 4 minutes of that second quarter. But Reese involved on offense is a good thing for LSU.
What's the halftime message to Auburn? How do they get this crowd's wild? It's probably good that they're in a locker room right now. What do you do in the second half?
Well, someone's got to step up and attempt to take a shot, because what LSU is doing is they're running a pack line defense. They're not overextending it. They're forcing they're forcing Auburn to look and say, hey, am I going to take this shot or not? And so they're second guessing themselves. Get into rhythm. Maybe set your ball screens a little bit deeper so your guard play will feel comfortable. But to me, the defensive scheme of LSU has really thrown Auburn off.
I thought the way that they started this game in terms of Auburn, they looked like they were taking it right at LSU,
absolutely,
right? Wow, look at the way they're starting. To close that quarter out, I thought that they looked a little bit timid offensively. And then the second LSU felt that, they pounced, right? And you saw them turning them over and being able to score off those. So I think it starts with honesty, Scott Grayson. Obviously, Sydney Shaw hit some big buckets for them. She got two fouls, so she had to sit on the bench. So I think she's a key player that can that can hit some perimeter shots.
10-point lead right now for LSU. Again, a 12-zip run to end the half, 15-2 going back a little bit farther. How about South Carolina with a win against Alabama? Knew that it.
Y'all comment so fast, it takes me a minute to see them. I know I was trying to see the buzzer beater again. I see Iowa lost again. They always do so much when they lose. Like, when we lose, we still have to keep it classy, shake their hands, and lose. Them, you get Caitlin falling, you get an ambulance coming, her security escort. You had their coach cussing out people and using cuss words to players. Girl. I'm so tired of this combo, y'all. Y'all, we talk about the Haley Powell point guard shit every single game. I don't know. Kim Mulkey says she keeping shit the way she keeping it. It is what it is. Girl. We already know they won. We gonna cover them when they don't win. Oh, no, because y'all saw what was happening on Twitter with South Carolina versus LSU again. All week we've been on by. South Carolina fans was talking about us. They mad Morrow didn't go to LSU. She didn't take the meeting with Dawn Staley. That was disrespectful. They stole our play that we was using all year. I don't care. We was using that play all year. oh, high school boys do this. Well, Milwaukee was doing it all year, so. But my girl, Ja'Kyra, she be eating the South Carolina people up. Okay, here it go, here it go.
For two from the field. Poas is finding open lanes. For two from the field.
They just posted the one of Flasher
today.
Oh, that was the tip back in. That was cute. Anyways, what y'all saying now? LSU be the shadiest, though. Girl, you already be on both sides anyways, so I hate the hybrids because the hybrids always say, oh, LSU wrong. Clock it. Yes. There's some hybrids in here, y'all. They know we're the show. They can't not watch us. We're too fun to watch. Like, even if we lose, still fun to watch.
So he was happy to read the disclaimer on TurboTax.
Guys, I won't wake it up, but I love this team. Let me see what y'all saying. Get them out. I know. I didn't know that Alexis had one more year and she could have came back, guys. I wonder why she didn't. Wake it up, wake it up, wake it up, wake it up. Are y'all saying wake it up? I'm saying it. So, all the tea, let me see. Let me take it off real quick. Then I'm going to wake it up.
Really get into it. Really get into it. Really get into it. Bow, fuck it up, get it more. Really get into it. I'm really get into it. Really get into it. Really get into it. Bow, fuck it up, get it more. I'm really get into it. I'm back in that mode, I've been on the road. You clutching that pole, you better blow. Cause if I thought it on me, I won't miss. Rent it up, ain't went broke since. I be jumping crispy, I be throwing fits on that same shit. I'm on some new shit. I want Fendi, I want Gucci, I want Lou, bitch. I got 50, I got blues, man, I'm so rich.
Say it, cheesy. We gon' do this shit like this for the city, man.
I can't do this thing called life.
Put New Orleans on the fucking map. Throw your ones up. All right.
Keep loving me the way
you love. One time, you gotta rock your hips. Rock your hips, 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 you gotta dip with it. Dip with it, you gotta dip with it. Dip with it, you gotta dip with it. Dip with it, you gotta dip with it. Dip with it,
dip with it. Dip with it, dip with it. Pussy.
These are our best burgers ever.
Tommy John is for men who value themselves and their comfort, who want fabrics that are lightweight, breathable, and insanely soft, with staple waistbands that adapt for the perfect.
Rolling up at the back, got that smoke in my lungs, young. On the block with his hand on his gun. One up top, cause they prepared where I'm from. Let your drop, they can't be scared where I'm from. Fast forward, from my play for
know,
your baby.
Bro, and nobody wanted to listen to her. Everybody wanted to listen to her when they thought she was about to say something about Kim Balky and Angel Reese at that whole whatever happened at the beginning of the season. Get the foundation. Why is everybody, what's going on with Cardoso? First, we see her push a girl overseas and she's no longer in Brazil. Now she's back and she's no longer, she didn't play tonight with South Carolina. Is Dawn Staley lying about what's going on with Cardoso? Like Kim Balky was accused of, or no?
Rockstar is just how Doug feels when he uses work day.
Thanks, Rory.
What's going on with Cardoso, guys?
I'll show you Rockstar.
Angel missed the game for one day. Workday for Angel missed a few games. There was a whole bunch online about her.
Ever since you discovered Zesty hidden.
They're at the game tonight. Play treaty lovemaking. Oh yeah, I heard that play. Nobody released what was going on with her. She not gonna be back for the rest of the year or something. Y'all let me know. Yep, it's coming back right now.
That first frame, Courtney Lyle and right, Carolyn
guys,
Peck
back
with you. How did LSU be able to catch back up and grab a 10-point lead before the break?
Well, I think the biggest thing was how LSU ended both quarters, the first quarter and the second quarter. Not only last second shots, but they were threes, big threes, and I think that really helped them to extend their lead.
Yeah, right at the buzzer, the first one coming from Haley Van Lick at the end of the first quarter.
You've got to practice and be prepared for situations. So then at the end of the half was Flaje Johnson, two, calm, cool, and collected, ready to take that big shot as the half was coming to an end.
LSU also turned up their defense and their rebounding. Look at the rebounding margin. Auburn was plus one at the end of the first quarter, but 10 minutes later, LSU plus 10 in that category.
Kim Mulkey coach teams are going to hang their hat on cleaning the glass, and they did that in the second half. But the first meeting between these two teams, Auburn was able to hang with them. Will they be able to close this gap in the second half?
We've seen, too, how good LSU can be out of the locker room after a pep talk from Kim Mulkey. But they'll give up a transition foul. Jemiah Mingo-Young gets herself to the free throw line.
It is so important. Who is going to establish and dictate coming out of the locker room?
Haley Van Lith whistled for her first foul.
And I think it's really important when you're on the road and you're playing the reigning national champions that you want to deliver the first punch coming out of the locker room. But for LSU being at home, the quicker you can get this crowd back into it, the better.
And when the PMAC is rocking, watch out. Those two buckets are the first points for Jemiah Mingo-Young in this game. She averages 9 a game. Van Lith to Reese, guarded by Scott. And almost turns it over. I think they call it a kick ball.
Savannah Scott is doing a nice job, though, of making Angel Reese have to catch the ball off the block, off the lane line.
Scott got in a bit of foul trouble, though, had to sit in the first half. She's got 2 fouls now. Van Lith running out of time. Into Flage Johnson, shakes the defense. Bates with a bucket.
That mid-range, little shot fake, old school, gather, and then finish.
Caitlin Duhon over to Mingo-Young. And Haley Van Lith picks up her second foul, both of them coming within the first minute of this quarter.
See, a team that uses a lot of the shot clock, when you're on defense, they make you have to be patient defensively. And I think that that makes Haley Van Lith a little anxious. She wants to get a steal. She wants to speed things up. But you can't foul.
Caitlin Duhon from the elbow.
The LSU gambling, playing Auburn, going underneath those ball screens. Can Auburn continue to hit those shots?
Michaela Williams elevating. Flage gets it back, and it's poked away by Scott Grayson. We'll stay with the LSU Tigers. Auburn's made it really difficult for LSU to inbound the ball.
Well, the communication on screens and letting players get through has been nice.
13 points, 9 rebounds for Angel.
And not a whole lot you can do about that. When Angel Reese gets position on you, she is so aggressive in attacking the rim.
Again, projected to be the 6th overall pick in the WNBA draft this year if she decides to come out. That's a 2 for Scott Grayson, and it's blocked.
Oh, I thought that was a foul.
Up ahead to Van Lith, over to Flage. There's where you see the chemistry for LSU show up.
They just feed off each other, and they celebrate, want to see each other do well.
Wow, a lot of contact, no whistle. Honestly, Scott Grayson slowly gets up and makes her way down the court.
Flage Johnson holding her knee.
Johnson is down and Scott Grayson is down. Before the ball made it to Flage, she was holding that left leg, the one that has the sleeve on it. Flage able to make her way off the court. She'll be replaced by Poa, and Haley Van Lith has whistled for her third foul, all of them coming here in this quarter. Now Flage holding that right leg.
I didn't see anything, a collision happen.
Mingo Young gets the first.
See if Poa has that kind of impact we saw against Alabama. It was in the third quarter. I think that Poa has started to take some ownership of knowing she can be that spark to turn things around, to turn things up for LSU.
What does it look like when she sparks them?
She'll make a defensive play. She'll deliver a key assist. And she brings the energy. I like the emotion that Poa brings to the floor.
Third foul on Savannah Scott. Back to the free throw line. Angel Reese, her second favorite place. Say the first is getting a rebound and a putback. Don't know that for sure, but that's my guess.
I'm watching Angel Reese at shoot around this morning. Before shoot around, actually, she was working with Gary Redis. And I think a question mark for a lot of GMs is, does she have a face-up game? Well, I sat out here and watched her. She is working on her three-point shot. So working on that face up, working on a turnaround, fade away, so that if she does go to the next level in the WNBA, going against the strength and power of the players, does she have things in her bag to where she can be effective offensively?
In the game, I mean, you don't see her take many threes. That's not where LSU wants her to take shots from. She's only 1-for-7 from behind the arc because they need her to work down low.
Well, this is the thing. This is not an audition for you to make a WNBA roster. Right now, Angel Reese's mindset is she wants back-to-back national championships.
She's got a double-double in this game, 15 points, 10 boards, her 17th double-double of the season. That's top six in the nation. Taylen Collins whistled for her second foul. And good to see Flage Johnson back in the game. They rubbed some kind of cream on that right leg. And now she's back. She's got double figures tonight, 11 points. And they immediately go to her. Offensive foul on Flage. Second personal.
Now you come back in the game. You know, sometimes you just got to let the game come to you.
Scott Grayson has yet to score here in the third quarter. She had 17 in the first half. Almost a turnover. Sumbane into Collins. Blocked by Morrow.
She said coming to LSU, really wanted to work on the defense, and she has had a presence for LSU, whether it be in the paint or on the perimeter. Defense is definitely a part of Morrow's game.
Got Grayson with the quick bucket. And a foul underneath. Count the two.
They called this foul on Angel Reese. Oh, the hook and hold on Simbane.
That's the fifth team foul, so that puts Celia Simbane at the free throw line. Up and in for two, and then just like that, a 6-0 run for Auburn.
That's key. A team that's built on defense, can they get a stop?
They're just swarming LSU right now.
Oh, and a foul on Poa.
Her second.
So Auburn should be going to the free throw line.
They just called it out of bounds. It wasn't a foul, though.
Oh, no foul
no
was called.
No foul on Poa. They just out of bounds off of last tier Poa. Mingo Young's going to take the three.
Smart by Scott Grayson, not just to turn up a quick shot.
8 seconds. Mingo Young all the way through to a waiting Caitlin Duhon, overshoots. Offensive foul on last tier Poa. That will be her second.
Ooh, Monkey's not happy about that.
Kim Mulkey did not like it. 6-0 run continues for the Auburn Tigers.
What even is this?
Don't touch my things, gross.
Janice, when you bundle your home or renters with your auto, Progressive provides 24/7 protection for almost everything you own. But do you really need
my weighted hoop? It's for my snatched waist. It's my dog chase lounger. Foot treadmill. That's my Tuesday chalice. Purse that says purse. Hyperbaric oxygen therapy chamber. I can't live without oxygen. Solid gold coffee machine. Lake making kit.
Really?
Can Progressive cover that too?
Yes, but...
Hi, it's Janice. I'll take five. Is my voice on TV right now?
Here's one thing we can all agree on. Having more choices beats having less choices. That's why we make a range of Ford F-150 pickups for any job. Whether that job is getting heavy things where
discipline. I'm being consistent this time around, that's what the difference is. If you don't believe in your dream, what make you think they listening? And I know that it ain't problem, but I know I keep on grinding.
Take you back to this last foul call. Remember, in women's basketball, the arc on the floor, that went away this year. So this is a charge call on last tier Poa.
One, early on, as Poa was driving, that offhand, she's pushing off. Now, I know she's trying to protect herself from all the activity, the aggressive play, but Kim Mulkey wanted the call on
the defense of Poa driving, but it could have gone either way. The officials could have called Poa for that push-off as well.
So something to keep an eye on, that was last tier Poa's second foul. Auburn is on a 6-0 run. Here in the third quarter, LSU has had four turnovers, and Auburn scored 6 points off of those turnovers.
It's a thing. It's been like an eye on the stove, turning it hot and cold. Both teams' defense have gotten hot at different times. That's what has ignited each team's run.
As long as they don't turn it off for the next quarter and a half.
Yeah, you don't even want to turn it down to a simmer. You want to be high, especially in the second half, for the rest of the way.
Oh, rolled all the way around the basket for Angel Reese and out. Scott Grayson, a 10-0 run.
I go back to Angel Reese.
They do. In the high post, working on Collins, they wave off the basket.
I see Scott Grayson kind of went silent at the end of that second quarter. Now late in the third, she's finding her offense again. First it was against Flajay Johnson, this time over last year, Poa.
Remember in the first meeting in Auburn's win over LSU, Scott Grayson had 21 points. Well, tonight she has 23.
And we're just in the third quarter.
We are. Taylen Collins picked up her third foul. She'll take a seat. Yakaya Milton back in. Too easy.
Yeah, when you need a bucket, LSU down the stretch, you've got to find number 10, and underneath out of bounds, a good screen by Haley Van Lith bought Angel Reese just enough time.
And that's the third on Milton, so Auburn's got to be careful here. Taylen Collins, Savannah Scott, and Yakaya Milton all have three fouls.
That's a tall order because the way that Angel Reese and Anissa Morrow attack in the paint. The one thing that we have not seen from Auburn yet is a zone. And with LSU doing their damage in the paint, a zone may be an option.
LSU 2-for-4 from three. But again, a team that does most of their damage in the paint, like you said, 45 points a game come from the paint for LSU. 7 seconds. Three, Scott Grayson elevates, short. Van Lith up ahead to Reese. And a turnover back in Auburn's hands.
Oh, Kim Mugney didn't like that one. She wanted Angel Reese just to catch and go score. I think at times Angel Reese can be a little too unselfish. Yeah, that's on Flajay,
her third.
This is where the free throw can be extremely valuable, with Auburn already getting themselves into the bonus.
That's the first time that Auburn has missed a free throw today. They were 9-for-9. Notice I did not say that before she shot.
I was watching. Are you afraid of the announcer jinx?
No, but other people are.
You did that.
I did not.
Oh, Angel Reese is getting a lot of contact.
That's four on Yakaia Milton. It's a really physical ball game.
Yeah, and in guarding Angel Reese, what you want to do is release contact, move your feet, and get around her. Make her have to readjust with footwork, not physicality. Because she can get your body sealed against hers, and then she can use you.
Auburn has outscored LSU here in the third quarter, 16-12. Duhon was looking for the pick and roll, wasn't there. Mingo Young for the triple.
Oh, that is gigantic for Auburn. Mingo Young knocking down that three.
They are 6-for-11 from three. Again, a team that shoots 26% from behind the arc is shooting over 50.
Well, this is preparation of understanding that the defense is going to go behind the screen. Last year, Poa attempted to, but Mingo Young didn't even use the screen. As far off as Poa was, she had enough time to light it up.
A 19-12 advantage now for Auburn in this quarter with Poa at the free throw line. Marshawn Bostic checks back in, replacing Duhon, who just picked up her third. So now that's three players for Auburn with three fouls, one with four.
Well, and Auburn right now has four guards on the floor. Somebody's at three. So you've got Sydney Shaw, Mingo Young, and Marshawn Bostic.
Johnny Harris is going to call a timeout. Tight contest in Baton Rouge. We step aside, 54-49, LSU.
What y'all thinking? Y'all let me know in the comments what y'all thinking, what y'all thinking.
Shayla seven. Maybe we had too much tequila. Actually, yeah, we definitely had too much tequila, because I don't know why we were playing on the phone right now. I'm gonna just block you. Bye.
If these diamonds in my head can't weigh me down, what makes you think you could weigh me down? Stop it right now. Friends were pessimistic about our love. Heard they tight now. We both know they're miserable at home. Come on, if this rollie on my wrist can't weigh me down. What makes you think you could weigh me down? Stop it right now. Friends, they like it better when you're down. Let's not talk about it. It's just you and me. I just wanna pull up the Maybach and bend your leg back. Please obey that, don't delay that. My love, why lie? Been a shy guy all of my life. We should change that, pull up the Maybach and bend your leg back. Let's engage that, don't delay that. Your life, I need her. Life's a haystack, friends, they can leave her. You could stay back.
I could stay back, I could take that. Calm and lay back, on our way back. Make a movie, watch the playback. Nah, don't save that, I don't play that. Penny, 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 penny whining. I rap really wanna taste the icing. Yellow fee, I give me my team. Commission for the game that I be providing. I was in Trinidad, let us consider that. Immigrant to a boss, just bitter and mad. Popping out like a cork, ducking them like Bjork. Just get out of line, I get them more than them talk. I tell them send a jet, a Valentino drip. See like the way you grip, my hips cupping my breath. Shading like silhouettes, spinning like pirouettes. It gave nothing, thank you for zero net. Damn, Trisby, another bit of rest. Shut up my internet.
I just wanna pull up the Maybach and bend your leg back. Please obey that, don't delay that. My love, why lie? Been a shy guy all of my life. We should change that, pull up the Maybach.
But she has battled through a lot of physicality delivered by the Auburn Tigers. And she doesn't, there ain't no back down in number 10 in white. Angel Reese, she is preparing herself for the next level.
When you take a look at her draft grades, again, she's projected to go sixth in this year's draft if she decides to come out. How do you grade her up, Peck?
Well, her motor, I give it an A+, rebounding, because if she misses a shot, she's going to get her own. If somebody else shoots it, she's going to do everything she can to go get it. And then her versatility. I talked about the question mark of her face-up game. What I have seen her work on outside of practice shows that her ceiling, she's got a high ceiling, that she can continue to improve and grow and can really be a force at the next level.
We mentioned it before the break. Auburn has four guards on the floor right now. Offensively, how can they work against LSU's defense with this lineup?
Well, what they've got to look to do, especially finishing the third quarter, being a bonus, spread the floor and look for opportunities to drive. You want to get something going to the basket, and if the rotation's there, then take that three.
Rashawn Bostic takes a two. It's no good.
But Bostic's got to be a threat because LSU's playing so far off of her.
Held ball possession arrow to Auburn.
You know what I've always wondered?
And
watching Kim Mulkey coach, at times things will happen on the floor and she'll turn and yell at the bench. And I just wonder what the reserves and her coaching staff's like, okay, I didn't cause the mistake.
But it's a team effort.
But you have to absorb that. You got to help your coach, let them release a little of that frustration.
I think Anissa Morrow lost a contact. She was holding her eye moments ago. She's over on the bench right now for LSU.
And Auburn really struggling in the paint. Only 6 points tonight.
Sydney Shaw trying to elevate.
Now to compete with LSU, you got to battle on the glass.
Right now, LSU winning the rebounding battle 26-17.
There's no seams inside. And Aaliyah Del Rosario is a great backstop for LSU.
Morrow got her contact back in. She is going to the table right now to wait to check in.
And Mingo Young called for that foul. That's really unnecessary right there.
It's actually on Celia Sumbane, her first.
Oh, Mingo Young will be happy about that because she was ready to form a protest.
Angel Reese, 5 of 7 from the free throw line tonight. She got both, and I said her free throw percentage before she took either shot, for the record.
I'll get you a cookie.
Ooh, thanks. Angel Reese has 10 points in this quarter.
And seeing Auburn not having Honesty Scott Grayson on the floor, where's their offense going to come from?
Again, Boston not a scoring threat, so LSU just stays off of her. Halen Van Lith. And that one will be on Jemiah Mingo Young, her second.
She got up for that. I'd like to see it again. She ran it down. Did she get her with the body? I guess the slap down is what the officials are going to call that foul.
Both drop in for Haley Van Lith. It's a 6-0 run for LSU, although they have not had a field goal in the last 3.5 minutes. Auburn hasn't scored in 2 minutes.
And honestly, Scott Grayson back in the game to end this quarter.
She's in the corner, number 23 in orange at the bottom of your screen. Van Lith, the deep three. Almost tipped back in by Angel Reese, but no buzzer beater for this end of the quarter for LSU. Tigers still up with 10 minutes to play. They're on a 6-0 run.
What even is...
Ain't this what they've been waiting for? You ready?
I got Briz on the beat, he go crazy.
What you working with? Get your bands up. Oh, you ain't tricking? I'ma hit your mans up. Cold, hockey, fire in the summertime. He gon' keep the bills paid, cause he know it's fine. It's always in my business, JC, what you really do? I be at home playing fetch by a swimming pool. I'm a real big dog. What Scrappy do? Doing all that wifey, knowing he don't f*** with you. Post a girl in your dreams. I'ma hold it, bust whoever in between. Gangsta, JT, Medellin. Haven't heard from the ops, yeah, they ain't said a thing. I be damn.
Are you kidding me? And it's a tie game.
I can't believe what I am witnessing.
The streak wins it for the win.
Oh! SEC tournament will be here before we know it. South Carolina able to clinch a share of their SEC regular season title with a win over Alabama tonight. LSU sitting at second right now. Auburn with some work to do at 5-7, but still 10 minutes to go in this game.
You look at what a win by Auburn would mean. They to move up and tied with Vanderbilt, Texas A&M, and Arkansas. When you look at how tight this race is, that just tells you how competitive the SEC tournament is going to be.
Keep in mind, LSU is going to play at Tennessee on Sunday. Tennessee on a bye tonight, so they got the breather and able to stay at home and watch this game. The top four teams get a double bye in the SEC tournament, so that's why that line is there right under Tennessee. So I mentioned it, LSU has Tennessee left, and then next week they'll travel on the road to Georgia.
We'll be down in Athens.
We will be.
And Georgia gave South Carolina everything that they could handle just this past weekend.
And then they'll finish up hosting Kentucky here on March 3rd before heading to Greenville for the SEC tournament. Again, LSU projected to be a number 4 seed right now, according to Charlie Cream. Do you agree with that?
I think that LSU, you cannot just look at their schedule, but you've got to give them the eye test. Because the way that I have seen them play, they have a potential to repeat in getting back to the Final Four. I think that they're higher than their projected 9 seed.
What is it about them that makes you think that they have that potential?
Their defense has turned up. They own the glass rebounding wise. As long as they can take care of the basketball and execute their stuff on the offensive end, because their defense has gotten them there.
All right, Honesty Scott Grayson. 5 5 three-pointers tonight. That's a career high.
26 points so far tonight.
Her career high is 31. She did that earlier this season against South Carolina.
We talk about no quit. Well, there's no quit at number 23 in orange. She is hunting buckets tonight for the Tigers.
And Auburn needs her to do just that. Auburn's hit 7 threes tonight. Van Lith out to pull up. 5 seconds. Into the hands of Shaw. Shaw will pull up on the run. That's 9 points for Sydney Shaw.
If Auburn can put back-to-back stops, we're going to have us a nice stretch down the through the end of this fourth quarter.
Angel Reese blocks that one out of bounds.
Yeah, Angel Reese is such a force defensively inside.
Got Grayson coming around, and it goes behind the backboard. Flage with the save. LSU's last field goal came at the 4:04 mark in the third quarter.
And I'm still questioning it. Why wouldn't Auburn look at going a little zone? Because if the ball goes inside the paint, Angel Reese can make it happen. LSU has made 2 threes, and both of those threes came at the end of the first quarter and the end of the first half. That's it. The only threes that they've made.
23 points, 12 rebounds for Angel Reese. And honestly, Scott Grayson got clotheslined. That's the third on Angel.
Well, when Scott Grayson is coming through, Angel Reese reached and caught Scott Grayson on the neck.
It was a good look for honesty, Scott Grayson.
And every time she touches the ball, she's looking for a shot. You see her eyes automatically go to the rim.
How different from her freshman year at Baylor playing for Kim Mulkey, where she was a reserve, didn't see much time on the floor.
Night and day.
2nd on honesty, Scott Grayson.
She was a freshman. She was trying to find her way. You know, when you're making the transition from high school to college, there's a whole lot you've got to learn. And she came to Auburn, 2 different coaches, and she really, you have seen her confidence blossom. And especially under Johnny Harrison, putting the ball in her hand. She knows Scott Grayson's got to score. Wow.
Michaela Williams, just her 2nd field goal of the night.
And then Auburn knows where the ball needs to go. You've got to get the ball in the hands of number 23.
She's going to be fouled by Flage, and Flage comes up holding her left leg. That's the 4th on Flage Johnson.
Oh, you see.
She tweaks that left ankle.
Yeah, and grabs it right away. That's a double whammy. She's slow to get up, and that's the 4th foul.
She's going to jog off.
Yeah.
She's heading back towards the LSU locker room. We'll keep an eye on her.
And she had the full-time responsibility of keeping up with Scott Grayson. Now, Haley Van Lith has that assignment.
Scott Grayson blows 28 points.
Reese and Morrow up around the free throw line area trying to leave a lane, but turnovers. Can Auburn capitalize?
Collins cannot. Post pass a little too high up in the air for Angel Reese.
But you see what LSU was trying to do. Tried to pull all the defense high so they could have lob opportunities to Angel. But that's been well scouted by Auburn. You see, as soon as Poa gives it a look, defensive rotation for Auburn is getting there quick on the catch on the backside.
It's back-to-back turnovers for LSU.
Look at the turnover difference. Auburn only one turnover in the second half.
Angel by herself. Swatted away by Sumbanye, but she's going to be called for the foul.
Michaela Williams, a freshman. The length of the court, one-handed baseball pass to find Reese. Little Tom Bradius.
Not Patrick Mahomes?
Could be a little Patrick Mahomes. Yeah. Sure. Okay. I went old.
He's not that old.
But he's retired.
We think.
Da da da.
.24 now for Angel Reese. Flaje Johnson coming back in from the tunnel, heading back to the LSU bench.
Look, Auburn has caused LSU to really play at a high level. You know, when you're at home, you'd expect, you know, maybe you could hold Auburn down, really have a comfortable lead, but nothing has been comfortable for LSU.
Mingo Young misses. Auburn's getting the looks right now, but the shots are not close.
And right now, I say play through. I mean, honestly, Scott Grayson out of the game again.
So where do you go?
Well, you've got to run your motion offense. I think you put Sidney Shaw on one side, you got Eddings on the other, and Mingo Young really operating from the top. Sumbanye, she can drive it as well, and then have Taylen Collins inside to play cleanup.
LSU is giving the basketball back to Auburn. They've had three turnovers their last four possessions, but Auburn has hit just one of its last seven shots. Sidney Shaw, 7 seconds on the shot clock. LSU basketball. 5 minutes to go. LSU on top of Auburn, 64-56. SEC women's basketball. Go room.
Big carbon here like Mayweather. Tula come through and blow up. Got millions out there rap. They hate them, but they stole the flow. Get back in after back in coming. I stole the show. Don't run up on that. She a head case. All she do is shoot. I signed my deal up on the PJ and hopped out of parachute. I'm geeked on next week. Bout no more features. I might just stir at you. I'm geeked on next week. Bout no more features. I might just parachute. Yeah, glow. Stomp a little with some shell toes. Yeah, glow. Slapping rap and making bail. Yeah, glow.
been to jail on the big low. Where you been at? Mine, everywhere I'm working hard. Maybach and G-Wagon truck. Got M&M's in my garage. Quick to crank up on the you. Better not get me started. Locked in with the gangsters and players. My folks gon' keep it solid. Everything I got on new, it look like I got renovated. I'm cocky, when I was just humble, they didn't appreciate it. Young, wealthy, and ratchet, I'm the hood motivation. On top of the world now, they tried to underestimate me.
Get them glow.
Them fraudulent, you know you the truth.
Get them glow.
Stop overthinking, these can't fuck with you.
Get them glow.
Standing on business in these Chanel shoes. Before I let her play with me, I'll go eat some jail food on
gang. Yeah, glow.
Stomp a little with some shell toes.
Yeah, glow.
Slapping rappers and making bail.
Yeah, glow.
Two-tone Cartier, match the nails.
Yeah, glow.
No competition, these stale.
Yeah, glow.
Curry, no curry, my in layers.
Yeah, glow.
Say they get money, but I can't tell.
Yeah, glow.
Keep running circles around these snail.
Yeah, glow.
And my pumping up in the jail on the gang.
Yeah, glow. Yeah, glow.
LSU has won 16 straight games. That is in danger right now.
We fed off the crowd. I don't know who they are.
That was on January 14th. Auburn picking up its fourth top 25 win under Johnny Harris, beating this LSU team. At the time, it was LSU's second loss of the season. Right now, 5 minutes to go in this one. 64-56 LSU, but both teams struggling to score right now.
But the stars have showed up. You got Honesty Scott Grayson. She has 28 points and Angel Reese 25. Down the stretch, those are the two players that each team, their respective team, has to play through.
A couple of milestones that we're watching too. Angel Reese 5 points away from 2,000 in her career. Honesty Scott Grayson 3 points away from tying her career high. Reese got it back, and there's a foul on the floor. Fourth on Taylen Collins.
Angel Reese on the backside. Now her and Simbanye, they are hooked together.
Wow. Collins takes a seat with those four fouls. Poa short. Morrow saves it into the hands of Mingo Young. Poa tipped it. And LSU will take it back.
Look, Auburn wants to, Jemiah Mingo Young wants to press. Now LSU has 6 seconds to get it across half court. Ooh, the turnovers have been crucial in this fourth quarter.
Three turnovers by LSU in the fourth quarter. Quaze Johnson checks back in to a big cheer from the crowd. She's got 11 points, 6 rebounds today. And that's the ninth turnover in the second half by LSU.
I understand you want to get the ball to Angel Reese, but you've got to have good angles. That's on Angel Reese.
No, Anissa Morrow.
Oh. Ooh.
Her second.
So Reese has three. Morrow, is that just her second foul?
Yes. Auburn has not scored in 3 minutes. LSU hasn't had a field goal in 3.5 minutes.
And Flajay Johnson, she's got four guarding Honesty Scott Grayson.
The turnovers just keep coming for LSU right now.
Both teams going for the home run play. You got to make sure. LSU running with numbers. But you got to exercise some patience. Oh, good offensive rebound by Sambagne.
Mingo Young trying to break the scoreless streak. No. Sambagne again crashing the boards. But it's a turnover in LSU basketball. She traveled.
Now Auburn bringing the full court pressure again.
But they immediately fall off as soon as LSU inbounds the ball. Offensive foul on Michaela Williams. It's not pretty basketball right now.
Man, you just saw Kim Mulkey go to Haley Van Lith to tell her, go get the ball. She's got to be the point guard on the floor.
Neither team has scored in over 2.5 minutes. There it is, finally, Jemiah Mingo Young, and she's gonna go to the free throw line.
Mingo Young has continued to carve and carve and carve at the defense of LSU till finally she found the seam. She kept probing, and Savannah Scott with the post up was really a screen for her, for Mingo Young to get to the rack.
Jemiah Mingo Young, all 11 of her points have come in the second half. And she's 5 for 5 from the charity stripe. She had a 29 made free throw made streak earlier this season. 29 in a row.
You're gonna watch LSU overload. Overload opportunity.
Kayla Williams, no good. Mingo Young on the move. Jemiah's figured it out.
Here we go again. The Tigers versus Tigers.
Although LSU has been really good at the end of quarters today, outscoring Auburn 27-3 in the final 2 minutes and 30 seconds of each quarter. It's one heck of a stat from our crew. The third on Scott Grayson. It's been almost 4 minutes since LSU scored.
The turnovers, missing layups. They just got to settle down. And Auburn knows that LSU wants to get the ball inside. So the defense is flooded there. And it's more of a stationary offense, and they're just trying to pass. So it's everything is predictable. They've got to get more motion in their offense. It is. I was like, that was an off shot for Anissa Marsh. She's an 83% free throw shooter.
Auburn calls timeout. Auburn. Honestly, Scott Grayson, 28 points, three away from tying her career high. And she's at 5 threes, which is a career high.
Well, Auburn knows that they've got to play through their senior. Honestly, Scott Grayson is option 1, 2, and 3 for Auburn. And when she's aggressive, then easy things happen for everybody else. She is the reason that Auburn is in the game right now. And has an opportunity to make something special happen like it did in Auburn, Alabama earlier this season when they faced LSU.
Auburn has not beaten LSU twice in the same season since 1994. They're down by 4 here with 2 minutes left.
Now, Johnny Harris calling that timeout to make sure on this possession that they get the look they want. And with Scott Grayson taking the ball out, look for her to get it back.
Angel Reese almost poked it free. Duhon. Foul on Van Lith, her 4th.
Free throws down the stretch. Duhon is a 61% free throw shooter.
That was you.
Now, LSU doesn't need to be in a hurry.
And you just saw Angel Reese tell last year Poa, settle down, slow, take your time.
And understand that Auburn is going to be in the passing lanes. They're going to be aggressive. You're in the bonus. Get something going to the basket, because if you get fouled, you get to the free throw line.
A step back for Van Lith.
Did Van Lith say, give me the ball? She wants to take this thing over.
And ended a 6-plus minute drought without a field goal for LSU. Mingo Young, 2 more. Back to a 4-point game.
Van Lith is a gamer. She wants the ball in this situation. The little step back there on Mingo Young. One-on-one isolation. Boom, number 11, knock it down. She said, give me the ball, coach. I can win this thing.
Jemiah Mingo Young was just whistled for her 3rd foul. Last tier Poa at the free throw line.
Now Auburn's got 2 timeouts. So to make or rebound, Johnny Harris can choose to use it and advance the basketball.
And she will. Auburn will advance the ball opposite their bench. So we saw, too, in the first meeting between these teams, how good Johnny Harris managed the clock, managed the situations towards the end of that game. And here they are with another situation and time to work with.
Well, and what they've got to do is they've got to execute, first and foremost, get the ball in bounds. And you're in the bonus, so you don't have to settle for a 3. You got to look to attack the basket. Now, Kim Mulkey, she has 4 timeouts right now, and I've got to imagine that if Auburn scores, LSU is going to call the timeout, because Kim Mulkey wants to get the ball down in front of her bench.
Auburn has hit its last 3 shots.
Now, depending on whether Auburn gets a two or a three would determine whether or not, after they score, how quick they have to foul or if they have to foul the other end.
Honesty Scott Grayson will inbound for Auburn. Goes into Mingo Young. Scott Grayson, the three, short. Swiped out of the air, and Kim Mulkey furiously trying to call timeout. Ran onto the court.
It was the right idea, Auburn.
I'm not sure she called it quick enough in order to advance the ball.
We've got to see whether or not LSU tried to advance the ball with a pass. If that were the case, when Kim called timeout, she cannot advance it.
Well, they did. Angel Reese got the rebound and kicked it out.
Then LSU cannot advance it, so they still got to take it out the full length of the court. So it's a two-possession game. Auburn doesn't have to foul right now. They can get a steal or get a rebound. They've got time. And LSU got to make sure not to get a moving screen.
Into Van Lith. So then LSU takes another timeout.
And they still got to bring, LSU still has to bring it the length of the court, and they've got 5 seconds left on the clock.
I'm not sure why they called another timeout.
I'm not real sure. But I think to make sure, Kim Mulkey may have wanted to call that to make sure you don't turn the ball over. And she has timeouts to give. She still has two left.
But LSU, again, like you said, they're going to have to hustle to get this across.
Well, and I wouldn't put somebody on the ball. I would put an interceptor back and try to get a five-second call.
Auburn gets the turnover. Scott Grayson. No. Mingo Young, offensive rebound. Over to Collins, up and in. Now they can advance it. So Kim Mulkey calls this timeout before they inbound the ball, so she can advance it. And now they'll have one timeout left.
So with the full court pressure, having to inbound it 94 feet from your own basket, and Honesty Scott Grayson had a great look. She just wasn't able to finish. Collins with two, but it's still a two-possession game.
So how do you play this if you're Auburn?
Auburn, you got to foul because it's a two-possession game. It's under the 30 seconds, and otherwise LSU could keep the basketball. You're in the bonus, and so now the weakest free throw shooter is Flage Johnson that's on the floor. She shoots 72%. Angel Reese is at 74. And today, she's missed two free throws on the night.
LSU does have one timeout left, but they're able to inbound the ball, and Auburn hasn't fouled. They got a foul.
You got a foul. You got a foul. Too much time is going off the clock. I think Sydney Shaw thought she was fouling, but she just wasn't aggressive enough.
Yeah, there was 29 seconds on the clock, and now it's down to 17 before Auburn fouls.
Johnny Harris only has one timeout left here. I'd say a rebound on a miss and go full speed all the way to the basket. If you can save that last timeout.
Lapoa makes it, and so Johnny Harris will use that final timeout to advance the ball. But 17.4 seconds left, not a lot of time when you're down six.
Now I think that she's looking for a three. If you can get a three from Scott Grayson, fine. If not, then you got to go just score quick. And even go with something to the basket, a pass to the basket, a clear out, isolation that you can score quickly. For LSU, I wouldn't put a person on the ball. I would protect everything in the paint. You have somebody in the position on a quick shot to get a rebound.
Remember, both teams are in the bonus, so any foul by LSU would put Auburn at the free throw
line.
Y'all,
we saw Quita in here. Shout out Quita.
Now Auburn has no more timeouts left. LSU has one. And I think that if they aren't able to, unless they've got a breakaway on the other end, when they get possession of the basketball, you've just got to hold on to it, because now Auburn's got to foul you. You've got to understand that they're coming aggressive. If they miss, or if the ball is turned over.
Well, this game is not disappointed. Again, Auburn beat LSU earlier in the season on January 14th. That was in front of a record crowd in Neville Arena, in Auburn's home arena. So Scott Grayson is going to inbound here for Auburn.
And watch the inbounder, because a lot of times you can get back. But the defense of last year, Poa.
Missed the bucket, but took time off the clock. Back up ahead, Collins too far under the basket. And she's fouled by Reese, 6.7 on the clock.
Big mistake by last year, Poa. When she got possession of the basketball, she should have just held on to it. Trying to go for the layup. She's ahead of the pack, but nothing's easy. She should have dribbled that ball back out around to the top, made the defense chase her, make time run off the clock.
Taylor Collins gets the first.
Now LSU still has one timeout.
Possession arrow to Auburn.
Holy cow.
But 5.2 seconds on the clock. Down by five. It wasn't pretty, but LSU will take it. 71-66 win over Auburn, and they split the regular season series. Angel Reese tonight, her seventh 2020 game at LSU, 25 points, 20 rebounds. She's now 5 points away from 2000.
And she played a big part on LSU, dominating on the glass, out-rebounded Auburn. 28-42. When you got an anchor like that, these LSU Tigers can do big things.
We will hear from Angel Reese in just moments, but now LSU.
Everybody breathe now.
Five games
Everybody
in a row.
Now.
23 wins on the season for
it's
the
over.
LSU
we
Tigers.
Need
we send
them,
you
guys.
To the studio
we
now.
We survived.
What a game for Angel Reese, who we will be talking to in just a moment. 25 points, 20 rebounds. Nikki Fargaseppi, Sorensen, Dari Noka here with you. A full 30-minute SEC Now coming up momentarily as well. Give a lot of credit to Auburn.
Why didn't they watch
Right? It seemed like they had many opportunities to let this get away from them and never really did. But in the end, it's an L.
Like, this is for LSU fans. Anyways, guys, it's 10:19. My daughter's birthday is at midnight. My man's birthday is at midnight, too. I got to get my house together. Good night. Oh, wait, my girl's live. We got to hear her. Wait, I'm sorry. This is Angel Reese.
Buster sore just from watching the game. How do you describe playing in this game?
It was a tough. I mean, it was personal, obviously, because we lost to them the first time at their crib and them coming back in here. We knew what they had. They had feisty guards. I mean, honestly, Scott Grayson, she's a pro, and she does what she does. She does it at a high clip. So I think we did a good job second half containing her way better. And I just think we played together as a team and played defensively. So it was a good fight for the SEC tonight.
Well, this game obviously was going to go down to the wire, and you made some huge plays. But there was a point in the game where I saw you and we saw you go and get the basketball.
Yeah, I needed the ball. I needed the touch. I mean, I was dominating inside, and they couldn't give me the ball, so I had to go get it and then try to make a play as best as I can. And me and Coach have the kind of relationship where we can do that, so it was good.
What was your coach saying to you as the game was getting closer and closer to close it out?
Just keep being poised, stay poised, be a leader. I mean, I'm a vet on this team, and I'm coming off the national championship team. So just keeping the girls together, staying down, and having this atmosphere right here. We can't lose an atmosphere like that. So being able to have people like this come out, so it was special for us. But I think we stayed poised, and we did well.
Angel, what was more physical, you in the crowd yesterday or on the court today?
Man.
Well, you took a shot yesterday.
That's crazy because the guy that hit me, we went to high school together. That's so crazy, yeah. And he posted on Twitter. He was like, "That was my mistake for hitting you." But it was cool. I'm glad. I'm happy for our men's team, and then being able to come back into this environment, and the students coming back out, and the men's team coming back out to support us was great.
Well, what does this mean? What does this win mean for you guys moving forward as you're getting closer and closer to the SEC tournament? Obviously, you still got a few more games to be played in regular season.
Yeah, I think we're in a really good place right now. I mean, from our last loss, the Mississippi State loss, we took that and it was crucial. So just being able to learn from our mistakes, going into film and studying film. But, of course, we got to move on to Sunday. Sunday at Tennessee, tough environment, great team. So we're just moving on and taking it day by day.
You know, last question. Let's just keep it fun here. Nikki and I were wondering maybe at the tournament some blush help, like,
yes.
You know,
yes.
Some makeup tips. Are you open to that idea?
Y'all got to follow me on TikTok, but I use a lot of different blushes. Dior, Giorgio Armani, Fenty. I work at a lot of different brands, but hopefully one day I'll be the face of it. So, yeah.
I wouldn't doubt that.
We're looking forward to it. We need a little help here, though.
Hey, we're also asking about the red, though, right? The hair. You need a little more attitude with the red? What's it bring out in you?
No, this is just for this week. I mean, I'm going to switch it up back up on Monday. So, you know, I got to do it. I got to switch it up every day.
Gotcha. All right. Great stuff. Hey, thank you for spending some time with us. Congrats on the win, and good luck in the next one.
Thank you.
Thank you, Angel.
All right. She's fun. She's very fun.
Guys, I know you guys do not want to miss the game versus Tennessee this Sunday, but it's at 11 a.m. Central Time, and I have two Airbnb cleans that day. I will not be home. So is there anybody who is willing to stream on Sunday so we do not miss the game? Anybody who's willing to stream on Sunday so we don't miss the game? I'll put my email. You can email me if you're willing to, but guys, I do have two Airbnb cleans on Sunday. So I can't stream. So somebody would have to. So what you would need is you just need a computer. I use my desktop with my Ethernet cord plugged in. Or you could use your laptop with Wi-Fi. You just need Google Chrome. You need StreamYard. I'll send you all my sign-ins. So you don't need to pay for anything, of course. I'll send you my sign-ins. But somebody will need to hit me up to see if they can stream. I won't be home, guys. There's nothing I can do about this one. somebody emailed me, Miss Octavius, that's you who I usually talk to. Yeah, that looks like Miss Octavia, who usually comes up. Email me, please, and I will do a meeting with you and show you how to do it. Okay, so that sounds good. I'll do a meeting with y'all Sunday or something. It'll just be this game. Yeah, that's her. That's Miss Octavia. So we'll go with Miss Octavia. Love Miss Octavia down. Okay, yeah, I got work, guys. I had to let go of one of my cleaners. But we're going to do some interviews next week and hire a new cleaner. Okay, that sounds good. All right, so just email me, Miss Octavia, or I'll hit you up on TikTok if I don't get an email from you. Okay, sounds good. Well, it's 10:30, guys. I love y'all so, so much. This is a great win for us. Are we not? Yes, y'all say thank you to her. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. I'd be ready to put, no, that's not Teddy, guys. That's Wesley. He says the same shit like 16 million times, bro. Yeah, I gotta go turn up for my man's birthday. My daughter turns 3 tomorrow. Guys, God is so, so good. He's been so good to my family. Okay, well, we're out. Love y'all. Good night. I'll hit her up and we'll stream Sunday. Y'all have a good night. Have a good one. Good night. Thank you to everybody who donates to this channel. Thank you to everybody who likes the streams, who subscribes, who comes back every week. I wish you nothing but the best. Have a good night.